Metal finishing, the shine and sheen of industry in India. A glittering trade that is literally transforming the face of several key manufacturing and engineering domains. Marking close to four glorious decades, and with over 1,000 members and counting, the Metal Finishers Association of India, MFAI, has been supporting India's epic metal finishing industry in more ways than one. MFAI is a premier body of professional electroplaters and metal finishers. Established as a registered body in 1973 by a group of dedicated electroplaters in the city of Mumbai, the association has grown steadily and steadfastly with significant contributions to the growth of India's economy in its own humble way. The association consists of great diversity in membership, with representation in the form of various sectors of electroplating and metal finishing firms, research organizations, chemical manufacturers, laboratories, and academic institutions. The association aims to provide optimal benefits to its members and the industry. Located at the heart of Mumbai's industry, in the suburb of Goregaon East of the Western Express Highway, MFAI's swanky 2300 square feet coordination office serves as a base for the organization. It is a well-equipped space with state-of-the-art infrastructure required to facilitate business and ensure smooth functionality. It serves as a venue for meetings, conferences, and discussions of the patrons. An information center and library are also hosted in the space. At the core of MFAI is the governing committee, comprising 23 dedicated members. From the very onset, the charter has been that of a social enterprise, undertaking the responsibility of managing and facilitating the Indian metal and electroplating industry. As a representative of India's metal and electroplating industry on a world platform, the association is responsible for ensuring that there is international standard and quality and the awareness of latest technologies and advancements. With this, one can reap maximum benefits individually and prosper collectively. The association is committed to providing a common national forum for metal finishers, industrialists, designers, and professionals. It supports knowledge sharing, thereby fostering the advancement of surface engineering, especially the niche aspect of plating science and technology. There is also promotion of activities like seminars, technical talks, intensive training workshops, industrial visits, and more. There is also the participation as a member or affiliate of international associations or institutions with similar aims. MFAI organizes exhibitions and conferences of international repute every 3 years. MFAI strongly vouches for environmental responsibility. It encourages manufacturers and users to contribute by minimizing waste, using cleaner technology, and rightly treating the effluents. The association has organized over 400 technical meetings and over 100 seminars on a range of technical and management teams. In the year 1997, the association organized its first international congress on electroplating and metal finishing in India. Eminent experts from all over the world were part of this productive event. The second international conference and exhibition was organized successfully in November of 2002. And the highlight, Indian Surface Finishing 2006, a mega event held in February 2006 at the Bombay Exhibition Center in Mumbai. ISF 2011, held in Mumbai, provided a platform for direct interaction between manufacturers, equipment suppliers, researchers, application engineers, and end users. It provided an excellent opportunity to expand the horizon of business. The organizing committee extends an invite to exhibitors or visitors or conference delegates. Whether one is engaged in automotive, electrical, electronics, fasteners, hardware, jewelry, cutlery, plastics, aluminium finishing, nuclear, space, paints, coating sectors, or any other industry connected to surface finishing, design, or marketing. It is a place where exhibitors can showcase their products, processes, and services. And scientists and researchers from industrial research centers, national laboratories, universities, and other institutions can present papers on ongoing developments. In today's highly interrelated world of industry and commerce, a renewed vision of progress is based on shared purpose and commitment. Thus, by working collaboratively, we will truly advance.
Our goal is to provide a common forum for metal finishers, industries, designers, and professionals
to meet and foster the surface finishing and technology in our country.
Come be a part of the electroplating and metal finishing fraternity by associating with MFAI and enhancing your endeavors. The Metal Finishers Association of India. Discover an ever-growing industry with unlimited possibilities.
A very good evening to everyone. It is my privilege to welcome you all to this first webinar organized by Metal Finishers Association of India. We begin today's program with a presidential address from our president, Mr. Sunil Goyal. Mr. Sunil Goyal is probably the longest serving president of MFAI. He got elected to this position in the year 2012. Under him, two very important international conferences and exhibitions were held in the year 2014 and 17 at Mumbai and Delhi, respectively. In fact, the event held in 2017 was truly international, where we have the participants from China and Taiwan on all over the world, including South Korea, Australia, and so on. He also initiated the move to take MFAI to the world map, and rest is the history. I now request Mr. Sunil Goyal to address the participants.
Thank you, Mr. Singh, and very good evening to all the participants in this webinar. I am privileged and honored to extend a warm welcome to all the members of MFAI in this webinar. Friends, we are passing through a very testing time, all of you know. We are trying to win this war against an invisible enemy of humanity since March 2020. We are sure we will be victorious if we follow the mantras given by doctors and health wizards. That is, wear your mask, social distancing, yani do gaj ki duri, sanitize your hands. While keeping all this in mind, your association has started this webinar series so that we can interact with our members, we can share the things with our members. Today, industry is trying to come up and perform at national level. Friends, today we are going to have our series of one of the lecture by Shri T.K. Mohan on zinc and zinc alloy. Dosto, ye jo webinar hoga, har teen hafte ke baad mein ek ek webinar hota jayega, aur hum aapko Indian सिनेरियो में जो भी हमारे प्लेटिंग के ऊपर टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट्स हैं उनको हम आपको प्रेजेंट करेंगे। थोड़ा एमएफआई के बारे में बताना चाहूंगा, सब लोग जानते हैं लेकिन फिर भी मेरा फर्ज बनता है कि मैं एमएफआई के बारे में भी आपको शेयर करूं। हमारी एसोसिएशन ने 1973 में हमारे रजिस्ट्रेशन किया था कुछ लाइक माइंडेड लोगों के साथ, और आज ये कारवा बहुत बड़ा एक मेंबरशिप का प्लेटफॉर्म बन गया है। हम लोग मोर देन 1000 मेंबर्स। ये एसोसिएशन किन किन लोगों को मिलके बनाया? सबसे पहले इलेक्ट्रोपेटर्स, सरफेस फिनिशर्स, केमिकल मैन्युफैक्चरर्स, प्लांट मैन्युफैक्चरर्स, टेक्निकल कंसल्टेंट इन दिस इंडस्ट्री, ट्रेडर्स, whosoever is related with surface finishing can become our member. हम लोग क्या करते हैं एसोसिएशन में? We always try to help our members, take care of their interests, have seminars, print ISF journals. हर 3 महीने के बाद में हम लोग जर्नल लाते हैं। We give certificate course. ये सर्टिफिकेट ईयरली है, बहुत ही डिमांड है इसका। ये साल अभी तक नहीं हो पाया है। मेरे जो टेक्निकल हेड है मिस्टर जय शाह, मैं उनको रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि ये भी इसी तर्ज पे जैसे हम लोग ऑनलाइन कर रहे हैं, हम लोग वेबिनार माध्यम से जैसे प्रोग्राम कर रहे हैं, वैसे ही वर्चुअल मोड में हम लोग सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स की तैयारी करें, जिससे कि कंटिन्यूटी हमारी बनी रहे। हमारे यहाँ पे बहुत अच्छी लाइब्रेरी है एसोसिएशन के ऑफिस में, वहां पे कोई भी मेंबर जाके वो बुक्स को रेफर कर सकता है। इन इट्स एंडेवर टू ब्रिंग ऑल द टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट्स, ऑल द इंडस्ट्री अंडर वन प्लेटफॉर्म, वी कैरी आउट वन वेरी बिग एग्जीबिशन इन वंस इन 3 ईयर्स, जिससे कि क्या होता है कि पूरी इंडस्ट्री को नॉलेज पास ऑन हो जाती है एंड इट कंट्रीब्यूट्स इनटू द ग्रोथ ऑफ नेशनल इंडस्ट्री। जैसे कि आज प्रोग्राम ई माध्यम से हम लोग कर रहे हैं और वेबिनार है, तो हम लोग ज्यादा इसमें नहीं, हमारे इंट्रोडक्शन में ज्यादा टाइम नहीं लेंगे। इसके मैं सबसे पहले अपनी टीम, जो इस टीम ने, टेक्निकल टीम ने ये वेबिनार का अरेंज किया, उनको धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगा। उस टीम के मेंबर हैं मिस्टर जयेश शाह, अशोक संघवी, डॉक्टर सुंदरम एंड आवर मैनेजिंग ट्रस्टी मिस्टर माधव सिंह। और मैं चाहूंगा स्पेशल टीके मोहन को थैंक करना, क्योंकि एक ही कॉल के ऊपर, हमारी रिक्वेस्ट के ऊपर उन्होंने अपना टाइम निकाला है आज के लिए, और आज के पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन के लिए, वेबिनार के लिए वो तैयार हुए। और सबसे ज्यादा आपको मालूम है ऑटोमोबाइल इंडस्ट्री चल रही है आज के दिन पे, और सबसे ज्यादा जिंक एंड जिंक एलॉय प्लेटिंग का ऑटोमोबाइल में यूज होता है। तो ये जो वेबिनार है, जो सब्जेक्ट है, बहुत ज्यादा रिलेवेंट हो जाता है इससे। अबव ऑल मैं आज सबको, जो मेंबर यहाँ पे जमा हुए हैं, जो अटेंड कर रहे हैं, उनको भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ, क्योंकि यदि आप इसमें अटेंड करेंगे तो ही हम लोग इसको लगातार कर सकेंगे। और मैं चाहूंगा अपनी एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल को भी धन्यवाद करने के लिए कि उन्होंने हमको ये वेबिनार करने का परमिशन दिया और हमको सहयोग दिया कि हम ये सेमिनार कर सकें। तो दोस्तों, अभी से हर 3 हफ्ते 4 हफ्ते में आपको एक वेबिनार आता रहेगा, आप इंतजार कीजिए। और हर वेबिनार का एक्सपर्ट का एंजॉय कीजिए, उनकी नॉलेज को शेयर कीजिए एंड मेक मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट ऑफ ऑल। Thank you, friends. Now I invite our managing trustee, Mr. Madhav Singh. Madhav Singh ji ke naam itna bada hai, koi bhi introduction ki darkar nahi hai. Aaj ye IUSF ke secretary general hai, International Union for Surface Finishing ke secretary general hona itself ek bahut badi baat hoti hai. और ये आज वो पद पर अपना काम बखूबी निभा रहे हैं। हमारी एसोसिएशन के मैनेजिंग ट्रस्टी हैं और पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट रहे हैं और आज के दिन पे मैनेजिंग ट्रस्टी हैं। तो मैं उनसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा, तो शब्द कहें ग्लोबल सिनेरियो के ऊपर और अपने व्यू रखें। थैंक यू। माधव सिंह जी,
थैंक यू मिस्टर गोयल। Just to supplement what Mr. Goyal has spoken to you, we at MFI strongly believe that growth must have a reason and progress must have a purpose. With this objective and philosophy as our base, MFA has been working towards the growth and progress of the metal finishing fraternity in the country. This is exactly what Mr. Goyal Saab has spoken to you. That has been our philosophy in MFAI. Now, I would like to talk to you on the global scenario of metal finishing chemistry. Size for metal finishing chemicals is estimated to be $10 billion by this year end, $5 billion by the year 2025. Now let us look at the global market share by products. Which are the products we are covering in this metal finishing chemicals? The plating chemicals constitutes the largest part, which is 41%, 25%, cleaning solution 20%, and others 12%. The conversion coatings are basically the chemicals which are used on the surface to convert the surface to a more stable state, like the anodizing, the chromatization processes. Now, this slide tells about the where these metal finishing chemicals, which market segments these chemicals are being used. The largest contributor is automobile, followed by the hardware, aerospace, electronics, and construction. Now, as you may be knowing, and I have mentioned this earlier in my presentations also, there has been a demographic shift in the consumption of metal finishing chemicals products from the West to Asian countries. It is estimated that the current consumption of these chemicals in Asia is 69%, Europe 17%, America 9%, and others 5% of these markets. By the year 2025, Asia is expected to achieve a CAGR, that is compounded annual growth rate, of 5 to 6%. India will play a pivotal role in the growth of Asian continent with an approximate CAGR of 4%. The biggest contribution would be by China, by 5.5%. That's how the Asia, which constitutes of the 48 countries, will have a growth of 5 to 6% by the year 2025. That is average growth I'm talking about. Japan would be around 1%. In fact, it is worth noting here that this demographic shift is of great advantage to India. That is how India has become one of the biggest hub for automobile components that we all know. In Europe, Germany is expected to grow at approximately 1.5 to 2%. Remaining other EU countries will grow less than 1%. That's how this market has shifted from Europe to Asia. The strict environment conditions, rules and regulations, and the restriction on the uses of chromic acid and some other corrosive material are the reasons to limit the growth in Europe. In future is Canada, which, as you see here, is already growing at the rate of 2.5% CAGR. America is not expected to do much, 2%. As finishing, friends, there was a time we were unknown in IUSF. Now today is the time we are controlling IUSF. It's not a big talk, but that's the fact. Everything on the IUSF is being monitored from India. MFI is monitoring the operations of IUSF. Now, I would like to just invite you to the next international conference and exhibition to be held at Nagoya, Japan in September 2021. We, on behalf of MFI, cordially invite you to this show, which is going to be one of the world's largest show on electroplating chemicals and other metal finishing chemicals. So that is in September 2021 at Nagoya, Japan. Thank you. With this, I conclude my presentation on global scenario of the metal finishing chemical industry. Of course, Mr. Goyal asked me to also speak on IUSF, but this is the too short time to really speak on IUSF because itself is a big topic to cover the half an hour. Because of paucity of time, Mr. Goyal, I'm sorry, I will not be able to speak on IUSF over here. Thank you. Now, is Mr. Mahendra Bhai Kamdar there? Is he?
No, Mahendra Bhai Kamdar?
No, he is not.
Madhavji, please continue. He is not here.
He is not there. Okay. Now, here comes the...
Yes, Madhav Singh, I am here.
Oh, that's very great, very great.
Haji.
Namaskar. Namaskar, Kamdar Sahab.
Namaskar. Haji.
Let me speak few words about you, Kamdar Sahab, to the audience. Mr. Mahendra Bhai Kamdar doesn't know, nobody knows, it's not possible that anybody doesn't know about Mahendra Bhai Kamdar, doesn't need any introduction. He is the founding member of MFAI. And he was the past president, the trustee, managing trustee of MFAI. And he has been our guru. He has blessed us in our working day to day. And I would say that because his efforts and blessings, we are where we are today. Thank you very much. And most welcome, Kamdar Sahab, on this program. Thank you.
A very good evening, friends. Sri Sunil Goyal, Honorable President MFAI, Honorable Trustee, Managing Trustee Sri Madhav Singh, Trustee Sri Eknath Amin, as well as the Honorable Office Bearers, Council Members, and Speaker of this webinar, Sri T.K. Mohan, and all the members fraternity of MFAI. Season's greetings to all of you. It is a matter of great pleasure and proud moments for me for the efforts put in by MFAI team in starting this webinar on various aspects of electroplating, particularly as on today, zinc and zinc alloy plating, and maintaining continuity of communication among the members during such a precarious pandemic situation. Hearty congratulations to all of the team members, as well as double congratulations to my beloved Sri T.K. Mohan, who has taken the lead to explain the various processes involved in zinc and zinc alloy plating. Sri Mohan is a seasoned, matured, experienced and quite practical, having 4 decades of knowledge in the area of electroplating and metal finishing. Friends, all of you have heard what is MFAI, how it is functioning, what are the future of MFAI through my both the friends, Madhav Singh as well as Sunil Goyal. Finally, friends, congratulations to you all who are participating in this webinar, through which you will be more knowledgeable in this area. Once again, hearty congratulations to all the trustees, president, council members and participants, as well as special congratulations to Sri Mohan. Many thanks for inviting me to speak to you all at this webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kamdar ji.
Aji.
Here also your love, affection for the TK Mohan is shown, being seen here.
Yes. Yes. We are associated since last 3 decades.
We are really blessed by your presence here, Kamdar ji. And that has given us the encouragement to really move ahead. Thank you very much for coming here.
Okay, namaste.
Friends, our next speaker is the great TK Mohan, who would be speaking to you on zinc and zinc alloy plating. TK Mohan, again a veteran in this industry. He has been associated with CMF group of companies for more than 4 decades. But I'm just wondering, looking at you, you look so young. 4 decades, kaise kaam kiya aapne? I'm not able to understand that. And same is the case with MFI at various positions he has worked associated with last 40 years, more than 40 years. He had been vice president of MFI for 15 years. Friends, here we present Mr. TK Mohan. Before that, I would just like to mention one. The duration of this lecture would be 45 minutes, followed by Q&A session of 15 minutes. I now request friend, dear TK Mohan, to take over the charge. Mr. TK Mohan.
Good evening, friends. And Mr. Kamdar and Mr. Madhav Singh, thank you very much for your nice words about me. And I'm not going to waste any more time. And today, this is the first webinar of MFAI, and I'm going to speak to you about a subject. Of course, it's a very important subject in metal finishing, which is zinc and zinc alloy plating.
Hello.
See, today I'll be talking about different parts, different processes for zinc plating processes. And mainly it is, one is that vanishing cyanide zinc process, which of course nowadays nobody is using except maybe very few. Then came acid zinc, of course, then alkaline zinc, then zinc and zinc alloy plating. And trivalent passivates and top coats. See, I would like to say something about zinc plating history. And this is actually, if you very interestingly, acid zinc got its first patent in zinc plating. But hello. But hello. Yeah, but acid zinc plating got its first patent. But actually, cyanide zinc took over, and cyanide zinc was actually in practice till 1975 or something like that, something like from the beginning. Yeah, and but after that 75 or something like that, before 80, acid zinc took over the entire market, rather more than 50% of the market from cyanide zinc. Then, of course, if you really see, alkaline zinc came in the year 2000 or 1995, something like that. But before that, something like more than 50 years, R&D was going on alkaline zinc. But, you know, it was very difficult to get through. So it took so much of time. And something like in 1995, after that, things were very, very good. And then from 2000 onwards, alkaline zinc came into existence. See, I'll just briefly talk about various zinc plating processes. And cyanide zinc plating, of course. Cyanide zinc plating, of course, it was like it's going processes, actually. And it had its own problem because it contained cyanide in it. And then the advantage of definitely was there. It was very easy to operate. And the technology was available, easy to operate. And good throwing power and covering power. That throwing power means actually you can get the plating all over nicely. And the covering power also is LCD and high CD, that all these places will cover properly. And but the disadvantage was that it is a cyanide process. So definitely, you know, the whole world or everybody knows that cyanide is deadly poisonous. So it was very difficult to use cyanide in this process. And the global restrictions has what you call compelled the platers to move the system from cyanide to acid zinc. Then of course, it was not what you call, it was very easy to operate. So people were using it, but then after some time, maybe 1975, something like that, like it was not in practice much. Maybe 5% of the total people are using about. Then acid chloride zinc plating. This is actually potassium chloride and potassium ammonium based bath. And of course, alloy bath also is available. It's actually the very important fact is that minimum waste disposal is there. Then high screen. Yeah, high cathode efficiency, something like 98% of efficiency was coming. So, and outstanding brightness. Outstanding means, you know, that cyanide sevi, both jada brightness miltata, and very good leveling, ability to plate problem surfaces. Problem surfaces means actually is casting and all. Now, it's very difficult to plate in cyanide or alkaline cyanide zinc. So, it has got an ability to initial, like for example, 5 to 10 seconds, the plating used to be, you know, plating can come, like good leveling can come, and it's a high conductivity is there for the solution, less hydrogen embrittlement because of the efficiency 92%. And the principal disadvantages was it is very corrosive. Corrosive means actually it has got, you know, acid fumes coming out, so it is very corrosive. And yeah, sorry, there's some. So actually line tank is required for this. Cleaning is very critical. Then it's like routine maintenance is required. In cyanide zinc, there is no maintenance required. Even dust gaya to bhi, matti gaya to bhi, it can be used. Then routine maintenance is, of course, definitely there in acid zinc process. Poor ductility and high thickness. And poor ductility means it actually on the high thickness places where, you know, it can get, it's known as chip of Hosoktai, and it is temperature tolerance. You can't play it like on a very high temperature. See, this is a typical bath composition operation conditions of potassium chloride bath. Zinc metal, everybody knows something like this, 19 to 30 grams. And chloride is something like 150. Boric acid is something like 25 to 30. Wetter and brightener is of course proprietary, it is actually. And pH, it is something like 5. And operating temperature, of course, is 30. Babu? And typical bath composition and operation conditions of potassium chloride, ammonium chloride bath. Zinc metal, again, it is 20 grams. Total chloride is something like 180. Wetter and brightener, as I told, it's proprietary. pH. See, here the pH, you know, ammonium and potassium, that is the difference, actually. pH is around, you can work at 6. And operating temperature is something like 40. And current density is again very, very high. You can go up to 100 amperes. Okay. Then typical bath operation condition of potassium chloride and ammonium chloride and boric acid, along with cobalt, that is an alloy plating. But of course, that alloy plating we will talk about later. Because alloy plating here, what happens is that actually a minimum of metal, other metal is added into it, in ppms actually. See, this is actually some functions and of components in acid zinc, acid chloride zinc baths. This is only an indication, actually, raising and lowering. This is, of course, many people may not be keen to listen to me on this subject, but this is very important for a, you know, for a person who have the plating shop of zinc plating. So it's once zinc metal goes on high, high means very high increase of actually allowable. Current density is good, decreasing, draining and deposit improves covering power. The all-over covering means LCD and high CD. Good coverage you will get, and decreasing throwing power. Throwing power means actually the uniform, once that current applies, no, the uniform thickness it is. It's like a ratio-wise LCD and high CD. And once a lowering of zinc metal takes place, decrease in maximum allowable current density is there, increasing burning deposit, reduces covering power, increasing throw. So that is actually uniform deposit thickness. And if the chloride goes high, increase in bath conductivity, increases high current density burning, lowers high, cloud point. Cloud point actually is, you know, at a temperature beyond certain temperature, the brightener doesn't work, you know, brightener disintegrate into it. And so that's a thing. And this is actually a selling point also. Some people say there, you know, the brightener doesn't, you know, disintegrate on a high temperature also. Then low chloride, lowers bath conductivity, hazy or dull deposit in LCD, reduces coverage and reduces anode corrosion. High temperature, and it usually the brightener goes off high, and usually nowadays, of course, these are all, you know, the small platers ke liye hai, abhi ke bade bade jo automatic system mein, the temperature and all are very clear. And low temperature, of course, high current density burning and oil out brightener, and very high, very low. This I am talking about, high and low is very extreme. High pH within recommended range. Again, the pH actually, we are talking about very high, improves covering power and improves cathode efficiency. Again, low pH within recommended range, very low. That means increases throwing power and increases ductility. Ductility means it is bendable, yes, like that. High pH outside recommended range. The precipitate the brightener sometimes precipitate ho jata hai, then rough represented ho jata hai, low LCD coverage, dull hazy in LCD, and then low pH, of course. Bada kar dena babu. Low pH, high current density burn is there, white patchy deposit is there, streak pitting on the high current density. Now comes alkaline cyanide zinc free, cyanide free zinc and zinc alloy plating. This is the, actually this is the topic of the day. First, I have given some informations about the whole thing. And now this techno commercially accepted process arrived in India in 2000 and that's something like 20 years ago. But actually for 5 years, this process was not accepted by people, and the process stayed in the shell until 2005. Lack of proven chemistry resulted in a possible negative publicity, because mainly in India, many supply houses never had this process readily available for the satisfaction of the customer. So situation has changed now, and alkaline zinc and zinc alloy plating has become a preferred subject and preferred product to many of the industrial section. Babu. Yeah, thank you. Now the interesting fact, of course, I'll be just reading out Mr. Herb Jadul. He is the pioneer in metal finishing and electroplating. His book, known as Zinc Plating, in fact, it's known as Bible. You know, it is actually in the early 1960s when waste treatment requirements became stringent in Germany. I'll read out this, very interesting it is. Germany, Switzerland, and England, a substantial number of plating supply houses began extensive development work on such plating systems. Many processes were introduced into the market during these years, but while performing adequately in the laboratory and in the pilot plant installations, they did not prove to be a practical value in actual plant operations. It was then emphasis turned into the development of bright acid zinc process and low current LCZ, that is low cyanide zinc baths. This I'm reading because it is very interesting to understand. And then again, journey and milestones, alkaline cyanide free zinc bath, which consists solely zinc ions and caustic soda, and with the additions, usage of brightener agents, produced an amorphous deep gray powderly deposit over almost entire acceptable range of operating current densities. Then work on substituting cyanide zinc, which was continued, bath functioned well initially in the production and, you know, that production and lab situations. But after that, built in iron, which was complexed by the system. This resulted in a zinc iron alloy deposit having very high iron content. Deposit color became blue, black, and ultimately dark gray, black, and it has become very dark. And it was, which was unacceptable. But the need of the hour was a non-complexing, non-chelating addition agent, which could replace cyanide without causing much problem. And the effluent treatment is still, possible like that. Though, and the efficiency and the color characteristic regular cyanide plating system. Subsequently, now you know that the alkaline cyanide zinc is in the market. Then alkaline cyanide zinc, that is actually alkaline cyanide free zinc. It is known as ACF in short form, or we call it as alkaline zinc. The advantage is actually lower makeup costs. MS tanks without lining is sufficient for this process. Least toxic, you know, there is actually that cyanide is there, and that is of course very poisonous. Even acid, of course, it's not toxic, but it is also, it has got you know, health hazard. And excellent throwing power, low current and high current density. The ratio is something like 1.1 to 1.5. Very easy to operate. Earlier, it was not very easy. Readily acceptable, that chromate acceptance is very good, and non-corrosive. Principal disadvantage, of course, it's not a real disadvantage because this automatic units and big electroplating system and nothing is now a disadvantage, but initially it was a disadvantage. Fume extraction was required, less tolerant to impurities, and you know, the other plating, it was like susceptible to except that lot of impurities. Of course, acid zinc has a problem, but cyanide zinc, there was no problem in impurities coming into the bath. Good pre-cleaning is a must now here in alkaline zinc, and temperature tolerant up to 35-40 degree only was possible. Typical bath composition, operating conditions, zinc metal. See, here is the difference. Actually, zinc metal used to be 20-25. In the earlier system, and here it is going to be 6.5 to 18 maximum. It is actually 10 to 12. Barrel plating, of course, slightly high. It can be around 15. Then caustic soda, this has the two components in alkaline zinc, which is, of course, caustic soda is to be like 85 to 150. But here, one thing you can see, the metal to caustic soda, usually it is kept 1:10. That is, if the metal is 10, and caustic soda, you can keep around 100, 120, but it's better to keep around 130 because the solubility of zinc metal is very good in it, though that you can get more of what you call clear ions of metal in it. Current density is, it's very wide, 15 to 50 you can go. Temperature is, of course, temperature tolerance, it is very, very important. It can, you can work up to 35 degrees or something like that. And additives, of course, proprietary. And in India, most of the supply houses is giving this process. Like earlier, it was very costly. Now it has become much more acceptable and affordable. Zinc alloy plating. Here is today's main topic, which I am interested in talking. Introduction of zinc alloy plating system. Actually, requirement enhanced, like requirement was like for automobile industries. Every time they think of increasing the life of the component, so the increasing the life of the component, they need to make some changes in the plating system. And what they found is that if they add a PPM levels of other metals, like for example, iron and cobalt and nickel, the property of the plating has become so good that the life has become something like double, triple, and four times or five times more than what they were getting during the actual zinc process in the bath. So it was actually cobalt, iron, and nickel, typically a small amount. Actually, it is like an impurity you are adding into the bath. Actually, you are adding an impurity into the bath, because earlier when zinc plating, if a nickel or cobalt, or usually cobalt is not there, because in very big plating shops, what people used to do is that there should be a big tank of the zinc, something like 2000 liters, and baju mein ek dusra ek nickel ka tank rehta tha, and like that, the chrome ka tank uske baju mein. So all our enemies, nickel, zinc, and chrome. So what happens actually during nickel plating, some nickel plating solution comes into the zinc, and the plating shop or plating tank gets problematic, and they shut down, and they will, the engineers or technical experts should come and treat. Usually lot of time is spent, because they have to do a lot of treatment. So That is the reason I was telling that impurity, but impurity is added in a very small way. And by adding that small impurities into the zinc bath, what happens is that the color of that plating is not exactly the color of the usual zinc plating, which is like bright and shine. There used to be a slight changes, and we actually term it as a functional property, because functional property, there is no need of an aesthetic look. So people accept it because it is coming in most of automobile systems or automobile thermal acceptable, that especially engine bonnet, under bonnet products are there. I mean, fittings and all. So people are, or the industry is more keen on accepting this process, and this process is now available for the last 5-6 years. And on that Trivalen Chromate, Trivalen Passivation, we call it as, and if it is done, you can, from some 200 hours of SST, that is white rust, it can go up to 1,000 hours. And 1,000 hours means 200 hours means something like 5-6 years in the market, or in rain and all these dirt situations. So that will that's the reason now you will see your car and all, once you know that Fiat car, those saal mein jang pakadta tha, then now that is coming into 10 years. And a good car, if you are driving 10 years and all, there is no junk. So that is, this is the result of this, you know, that plating differences of mainly alloy plating and all. So zinc nickel and zinc iron and zinc cobalt, these are three metals, that is nickel and iron and cobalt, which is added into this alkaline cyanide fit. Typical bath situation is something like, for example, nickel. See, I told you very low iron, like nickel iron is something like 1200 se 1500. It is, see, it's in ppm, that is ppm means milligram. So you know, 1200 milligram is added into this bath. Of course, there is a the additives are different, and the operating condition, everything is like alkaline zinc only. Then you, the life enhances something like 5 times. Then the typical bath conditions of zinc iron bath, actually again 50 to 200 ppm of iron is added in an alkaline. It's not just adding, that systems also, that brightness systems also changes, and it can go up to 100 ppm. And 100 ppm, the color of zinc is, of course, plating is changed. It is very dull, but that doesn't matter, because this is usually used in a functional items. Same is the case with cobalt. Actually, the first, when the alloy zinc plating started, people were using cobalt, but that cobalt was added in acid bath earlier. Something like 50 to 200 ppm cobalt was added. Now, of course, cobalt is coming in alkaline bath also, but cobalt is not now in much favored, because the nickel has come in. So zinc nickel is much of in demand now. See, now actually this is the main topic of mine today: zinc nickel plating benefits and challenges. See, actually latest trend is becoming the choice of many industries, especially automobile industries. They are going for high performance needs, and it is rapidly growing in the segment where zinc nickel 5 saal pehle tha kitna samjho, it has become something like 4 times higher demand zinc nickel ka. So alloy has actually many properties. They are appealing manufacturers, you know, what you call the fasteners, casting, automotive and heavy equipment requirements. And most importantly, zinc nickel process is using in defense. And actually this is because this cadmium was used in defense. Actually, cadmium is now it is getting banned. In fact, now many places, in even America and all, totally. Of course, Indian defense also, they are not. They are thinking of. I think they are also that they are stopping cadmium, because what is the difference between cadmium and zinc? Cadmium, once it is like, you know, rust pakdega, the volume of rust is very, very less. Whereas in zinc, the volume of rust is more. And cadmium has got lubricity. So, you know, this defense means usually like, you know, the barrel of a gun or, you know, bullets. This has got that all this plating, cadmium plating, because it needs lubricity for, you know, actions. So that was not, it was not getting in zinc or any other process. So now in American defense, they have demonstrated by using this zinc nickel, and something like cadmium is getting replaced by zinc nickel. And here in actually zinc nickel for a wide variety of application they are using, and they exceeds all acceptance criteria for, you know, coating equally adhesion, corrosion, hydrogen embrittlement, because it has got low hydrogen embrittlement. And these kind of things has been implemented into Air Force overall facility, and it's being adopted by industry as an alternative to cadmium. So now that has been accepted, and now all many countries, they are using this, or they are up to using this process in and try to replace cadmium. So this is going to be a very big thing. Maybe years to come, this is going to be the market, zinc nickel. And another advantage of is that the zinc plating hardness is something like 100 wickers, whereas this alloy is becoming something like 500 wickers of hardness. So it is something like 5 times. So overall, zinc, of course, cadmium will be replaced by zinc nickel. And another advantage is that zinc nickel is coming in 2 processes, that is acid and alkaline processes. And one more thing is that zinc nickel can withstand more than 240 degrees centigrade anytime. That's why it bonnet, gaadi ka jo bonnet ke andar jitna bhi fitting rasta hai, like fasteners and bolts and nuts, all are now getting replaced to zinc nickel. And another advantage is that all nowadays, most of the plating, there are this functional items, most of the people prefer black color, and a black color ke liye zinc nickel is very good. So it's actually the today's topic actually is actually zinc nickel alloy plating in the total zinc plating. And actually alkaline zinc nickel and acid zinc, it has got different usage. Actually, today also alkaline zinc nickel is much larger market they are sharing, and complex geometry wala jata kacha kucha, we tell, know that LCD and high CD deep this thing, that alkaline zinc is better actually. And but acid zinc has got a dusra advantage of it can actually plate on casting and high carbon steels. Actually, casting, why this acid plating is being used is, casting has got pores in it actually, you know. So what happens, alkaline zinc doesn't have that ability to cover that pores, whereas acid zinc, once its plating starts around 5 seconds or 10 seconds, it jumps into a sort of pseudo plating. Jump marke wo cover kar deta hai, acid zinc. So initial 5-10 seconds, and after that, on that zinc plating takes place. So that is because of that only, people don't prefer alkaline zinc for this, and they prefer acid zinc nickel process. And this is actually, and another thing is that it can carry different current. So most of the items also they can plate, mainly this kind of things, so specialized items, they go for acid zinc. I mean, as in zinc nickel. This is a basic process sequence. Of course, this is a standard one. It doesn't, nobody tells you have to use this only. You can have any other, whichever is suitable. But usually, so clean, water rinse, then electroclean, water rinse like this, you know, all these things. And there is one nitric acid dip. If you are using an acid process, then the, there will be an acid dip, sorry, alkaline process, there will be an alkali there. That's all, there's a change. Then all this water rinse and all these are all, you know, nowadays, it's a standard one. There's so many, what you call, like they sometimes use three tanks, sometimes only two, like that. That all depends on, you know, the item and drag in, drag out volumes and all. And very important, there is one, that last blue big, the second last, curing 24 hours. That curing actually, it is a must for a trivalent passivation, because it actually trivalent passivation is not self-healing. Actually, hexavalent passivation, if it is thrown or, you know, if that cut, it will get automatically healed. Trivalent doesn't have the property. So the usage and after passivation, you have to use it very, very carefully. And then if something breaks and it won't heal. So actually, it needs actually a curing time of 24 hours. So this is where actually we, this platers has to be very careful, because I have seen all this, you know, that what you call the vendors, big companies, vendors, they should have, if this process come into practice, in the sense it has come into practice more than 15 years before, what happens is that the people who give electroplating items to the vendors, they should not be lifting this material before 24 hours from the factory, from the vendors. But most of the people, they don't do that, because their line is band ho gaya bolke aake, their tempo will come to the gate and they take that material before 24 hours and it will go into this fittings, and there it fails also, salt spray. So here the plater has to be very careful. After 24 hours only, they should move this material out of the gate. That is very, very important factor. See, troubleshooting of acid, chloride, zinc and other things are there, which I will definitely just go fast like that, because this actually, you know, this is of course very important for a person who is involved in zinc plating actually. And baki log, I know there are so many people listening to me, aur baki log ke liye kuch nahi hai ye, but for zinc people, it's very difficult. So I will just go through this, because if I read it, of course, it may take around 10 minutes and I don't want to waste anybody's time, because this is burn deposit possibilities here, there. What are the possibilities, and low water, high zinc and all like that, methods of corrections, check and lower. Like, see, the once if a burn deposit takes place, what will happen like that it is. And this is what, again, yeah. Yeah. Then pitted deposit, high brightener. Brightener jyada dalega to pitting aega. So accordingly, you have to reduce the brightener. Then high chloride, high temperature, like stained dark deposit after bright dip. Iron contamination hone mein. Iron contamination to both hota hai tanki mein, because especially in acid zinc, mainly acid zinc because what happens, iron get dissolved in it, and more iron, there will be definitely problem. Passivation mein wo kala ho jata hai. Then copper, cadmium, again copper bhi impurity mein kala ho jata hai, like that. Misplated, usually chrome rahega to hota hai. Chrome ka tanki mein si pani jayega to bhi hota hai, nahi to some of the passivation goes into the tank. And high brightener, like that it is. So slow plating, definitely there will be less anode area, thus less anode, low metal, like that will be there. Then methods of corrections, definitely you have to increase anode and all. This of course I don't think many people will be much keen about it, but since I am talking a subject, then I thought I should have all these things ready. Rough deposit, then white stains, excessively high brightener consumption, definitely. That actually, you know, that wrong ratio of brightener is added, and wrong bath analysis ho sab rehta hai. So these are the things that you can check it up. Blister deposit, of course, in alkaline zinc, you know, some of the system actually give a blister deposit. Deposits may blister aata hai. Otherwise, usually blister, that is actually known as latent blister. After 2 days ke baad blister dikhega. This is actually high brightener aata hai, poor cleaning. And alkaline zinc, you need a real good cleaning. Improper bath chemistry, organic contamination, like that it is. And so all these reasons, of course, you have to, what you call, check and correct all these things. Then dull low current density deposit, that is high metal, low brightener. All these things, many of the people, once people start using it, they all know. All these operators also know about it. But since, as I told you, these are the, troubleshooting and burning and deposit stained after bright dip, definitely metallic impurities. And impionitric acid, cloudy deposit, low brightener, high metal content. And zinc metal content keeps dropping, low anode area. Every time metal rate is so high, so people don't use anode properly. But always remember, if you don't use it properly, then you are a loser. Actually, you will, your material will come back and your plating product will come back. So it's always better to use and work good product and use everything, including anodes and all, like that. Then alkaline zinc free, zinc metal content keep rising. That is actually too many anodes you are keeping, or too many, there is a, zinc solution is kept outside. So it is pumped in. So sometimes you are putting in more solutions back to the bath, like that. And too high brightener consumption. That is actually, if a metal is high, definitely brightener consumption is high. Because metal high means, for example, in practice, if you are adding, if you in a 5,000 liters, if you add 1 gram of metal, and you have to add something like 3 to 4 liters of brightener, because every gram of brightener, gram of metal is increased, and requirement of around 1 ml brightener is required initially. Then, of course, it is worked with ampere hours. Trivalent chromate, it's a nice topic. Actually, what's happening is that these regulations, international, that is European Union legislation, what is happening is that hexavalent passivations is, it is now practically over. Nobody is using hexavalent passivation. And this trivalent passivation, one advantage is that, you will get, of course, for our nation, for our safety, it's good because we are not using hexavalent chrome. Environmental friendly ho jata hai. Then one advantage is that you can have a very high life, from 30 hours to 1,000 hours you can get. And there are three types of two types of chromates, it's trivalent chromium. One is blue color is there, one is trivalent yellow is there. But trivalent yellow is not yellow itself, actually. Blue is there. Time okay? Another 5 minutes only. Blue, actually trivalent blue is something like 30, from 30 hours, like salt spray to 150, 160, you can get. And thick deposit is there, that is trivalent yellow, which can go up to 250. And red rust, it can go up to 750 to 1,000 hours. So there are so many products available in the market. And on that, if a top coat is added, then you got different top coats. Polymeric based is there, silicate based is there. Then there is a torque tension coefficient on top coat. You can have that also. So that's it actually today. Today I was talking mainly on zinc nickel. I'm sorry, there is I have one mic in my hand. Usually that mic is not there. Usually it's a hand-free mic. So that is one problem I had. I've got, actually, I can't move around much in this webinar. So these are the problems I had in my speech today. And I'm operating myself, everything, when two hands are like this. So that's the thing. And I thank MFAI for inviting me to give a speech. And I thank Mr. Kamdar, Mr. Goyal, and Mr. Madhav Singh, of course. Mr. Jayesh is the head of the division here. He's sitting in front of me. And I thank Mr. Ali Bechu Ali, MD of Consolidated Metal Finishing Private Limited. In this company, I am here for more than 44 years. So I thank everybody. And I'm very sorry. This is not my usual talk because my hands are blocked with one operation here and one operation there. And the screen was very less and I could not see that screen with the chashma also. So I'm very sorry about it. Thank you so much. And if anybody has to ask any questions, and I am here to answer. And if anybody is there, maybe around 5 or 10 minutes is there, I think.
Mohan, you have 15 minutes for question answer.
Yeah, if anybody has got any questions, if I can answer it, I can do it. And if it is a difficult question, definitely, and nobody is 100% perfect, even I am not. So sometimes I may not be answer these questions. And if I can, I can do it. And there are so many experts listening to me, so they can also answer, but I don't think that will be possible. So if anybody has got any questions, if I can answer, I can do that.
Jayesh bhai, have you picked up the questions? Jayesh bhai?
Mohan sir, one question from the Mr. Pintu. Do we planning to have a zinc oxide nanoparticle splitting in coming days?
Yeah, actually, it's nanoparticle plating coming, but usually the plating, no, it's in actually top coats and all they are planning. I think it's car seats and all, no, car doors and all, or car, automobile. I heard it's coming, but I don't think in the near future it's there. I don't know. Yeah, anything?
Yes, bhai.
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No question is there, sir.
And from the participant, no question. So it means that Mohan, Mr. T.K. Mohan has explained this subject so well, people have understood it.
Yeah.
They understood it, Mohan, very well. Well done, well done.
Okay.
He can't hear us.
One question, I think.
What is that?
Mr. Bhaskaram, if block die, what is the salts? Is a block die? Oh,
dia.
Sorry. If block dia, what is the salts?
Of plating.
On plating.
Block die. You will be requiring an auxiliary anode for that. If for plating.
One more question from the Santosh, Mr. Santosh Rane. What is the alloy compositions?
Yeah Santosh. Sorry, I did that.
Of course, nickel. Nickel is actually alloy is 5 to 10%. It is better to keep less than 15%.
Santosh, and usually it is better to keep 10%. 5 to 10 is okay, because what happens is if it is going beyond 15, your salt spray reduces actually. Salt spray result reduces and color also changes into it. You know, it will become more not actually color. There is a change, but definitely you can keep from 10 to 15. Thank you, Santosh.
I have one question, Mr. T.K. Mohan. May I ask you?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Mohan, for continuous strip plating process, now which technology is better, the acid zinc nickel or the alkaline zinc nickel?
Anybody's there?
One more question from the Mr. Santosh Anevu. Of what is the nickel content in a alloy plating?
That is replied.
Nickel content only I was telling, na? 10% of the total. Means. Go beyond 15%, it is actually the life goes down. In fact, I was telling you about the deposit, alloy content only, Santosh. Rani.
Mr. Santosh has one more question. Way to analyze Ni in deposition.
Can you repeat the question, please?
Yeah, Mr. Santosh Rane again wants to know how to analyze Ni in deposition.
Can you hear?
Which one? Who's? That is that machine is there now.
Hello. Hello. Rane sir.
Santosh, excited
fishing. Santosh is a very good person.
Any more question from? Yeah, I ask you the question, Jayesh Bhai.
Aji sir.
For continuous strip plating process, the which technology is better, the acid, zinc, nickel, or the alkaline zinc nickel?
Sir, one more question from the Mr. Madhav Singh. Which is the better process for continuous wiring? Alkaline zinc or acid zinc?
See, actually for continuous process, acid zinc is best. And acid zinc with the ammonia. So the advantage is that it can carry high current. It can carry up to
100 ampere per square foot, something like more than triple, and a very high speed wire. If it is moved and is kept at a high voltage, you can get a very good finish. And one more thing, very ductile finish and very smooth finish. It is actually acid zinc with ammonium chloride, boric free.
Jayesh Bhai, I asked the zinc nickel process. I asked for the zinc nickel process.
See, zinc nickel process, of course, it can be, but the thing is that it is actually zinc nickel has got nickel in it. So wire, it is, you know, rolling, and you have to see zinc nickel. We have not used it so far. We have not used it, so it's new. I don't think it is readily available or readily can be done, because it has got nickel in it around 10%, or 1200 ppm or more. So that flexibility of the wire, wo dekhne ka hai.
वायर नहीं मोहन साहब, स्ट्रिप की बात कर रहे हैं. स्ट्रिप पट्टी.
सुनील शर्मा, विच इज द बेटर प्रोसेस, अल्कलाइन जिंक निकल और अल्कलाइन जिंक एसिड जिंक निकल?
question?
Yes. See, actually, in both cases, you have seen, you must have seen when I was talking about acid zinc and alkaline zinc. I mean, alkaline zinc nickel and acid zinc nickel. What has happened actually, the basically alkaline zinc nickel has come into use sometime like 5 years or more before. And that time also it was there, acid zinc nickel was there, but then the most of the chemistry had to use different two anodes and all different anodes. So again, I told this acid zinc nickel, you can do a plating on, you can do plating on casting, which is very, very important because actually, kya hota malum? You know, you've seen that nowadays that, big cars, wheels, you can see there is, you can see like hand gesture things, that is brake. And that is known as brake caliper. It is being manufactured with alloy, which has got holes and, it has got deep, like nazar se nahi dikhega. But it is jaisa well jaisa deep rata hai. So alkaline zinc, you can't plate it directly because it goes into that, then it come up. Whereas acid zinc, as I told, it has got a fast plating. It jumps on that, like you can jump out of that and you plate. So pura cover ho jata hai. So then that is very, very important for, that casting. So most of the things are being done with this zinc nickel, these kind of products. And another advantage is that it has got an ability to have a different, you can use a different, the current and all, so high and low. So it's more of acid zinc. So if you really ask me, which process is suitable, it is defined as you can have different process on a different, this thing.
Cobalt zinc alloy plating is possible?
Feasible, yes. Yes, actually, there was a time, maybe 15 years before. I know our Mr. Kamdar came, our managing earlier managing trustee. I think he was using this zinc cobalt so many years before. Actually, alloy plating mein zinc cobalt kai pehle hota tha, but that was coming in usually in acid zinc. And it can feasibility koi problem nahi. You can add that ppm of cobalt in it. Mainly, of course, dono mein dal sakte, but acid zinc is very good. And lot of companies are making it. It is usually from 50 ppm to 100 ppm, because or even up to 200 ppm you can use, and you will get something like 4 times or 5 times higher life in it, at least 4 times. It doesn't have any problem except cobalt jyada nahi hona chahiye, because kya hota high current density mein, then you will have a problem of chip off, like ekdam high current density mein. Time is okay, na time.
Good evening all. I am Jayesh Shah on the behalf of the MAPI. Extend to very special thanks to Mr. T.K. Mohan for sharing his fantastic knowledge on the zinc and zinc alloy platings and making this webinar successful. Also, thank you to all the participants for the joining the webinar on zinc and zinc alloys and staying connected till last. I hope everyone enjoy it and gain every bit of the session. Any feedback and the query from the can be emailed to us on MFAI mail ID. Thanking you once again. Thanks, Mohan sir.
Please. Thank you. Thank you very much. And next time we will have a better facility. Because especially this mic was giving a problem.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you, friends.
थैंक यू जयेश भाई,
थैंक यू।
हमारे पास है सब, आपके पास सब है।